بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وبعد. فقد قال جل وعلا في كتابه المجيد وفرقانه الحميد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فما آمن لموسى إلا ذرية من قومه على خوف من فرعون وملئهم أن يفتنهم، وإن فرعون لعال في الأرض وإنه لمن المسرفين. وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم: من سره أن ينظر إلى سيد الشباب أهل الجنة فلينظر إلى الحسين بن علي، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Honorable scholars, respected brothers and elders, Allah Rabbul Izzat has blessed the youth of every time with phenomenal talent and exceptional courage. But at the same time, they are extremely vulnerable and susceptible. Hence, if their talent and their courage is not harnessed and is not nurtured, the havoc they will cause and the problems they will create is worse than that of the adults put together. The lad that Khidr alayhi salatu wasalam was instructed to kill, the Quran said, فَخَشِينَا أَن يُرْهِقَهُمَا تُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا, that we instructed Khidr to take the life of this little child because he was going to grow up and rebel. But that's not all. He was going to influence his parents also into disbelief. Hence, I often believe, and I commonly say this, that a youngster never moves by himself. If he advances in good, then with him he takes a nation. And wallah, if he plunges in sin, then an entire nation drowns with him. But at the same time, if this very young man, his talent, his capabilities is nurtured, is harnessed, the value he can add to society, and the horizons he will explore, and the heights he will climb, wallah, it will take decades and generations to achieve this. The salient feature of a young man is courage. Nothing is too daunting for him, nothing is too challenging for him. In fact, by his nature, he likes things that are challenging him. Things that would challenge him, this is by his nature, he likes it. Unfortunately, the slogans that are being chanted today and the whispers that are being echoed is to provoke this young man to abuse this courage of his. So typically, a youngster, when he's sitting with his friends, then what are the echoes that have been whispered to him? I dare you to needle it to 200. I dare you to pop 10 pearls. I dare you to hood for this girl and flirt this woman. Now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ash-shababu shu'batun min al-junun." Youth is a portion of insanity. So you're not talking to a man whose sanity is in, who's got his composure. He's lost his sanity. This is his courage. And these are the provocations. You can imagine the chaos that is going to be caused. If only we could communicate the right message to this young man via the very billboard that is advertising nudity or semi-nudity. If only we could seize the marketing opportunities via the cell phone and communicate messages of morals and values, by virtue of which we could protect the fabric of our society, then trust me, this young man has the talent. He and wallah, he alone, to rise up to the challenges and to face the dictators of his time. It is only the lot of the young man who will stand up and have the conviction of his courage, even if it means looking at him naked in his eye. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam when he embarked on the mission to destroy idol worship and to establish monotheism, the doctrine of one Allah. Allah made categoric reference to the fact that Ibrahim did this year in the context of the verse. قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا فَتًا يَذْكُرُهُمْ يُقَالُ لَهُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. When Ibrahim embarked on this mission, make no mistake, he was a young man in the prime of his life. He was a youth that was brimming with his youth. That is the time he embarked on this mission. Prior to the coming of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wassalam, because of the tyranny of Pharaoh, generally the people anticipated the arrival of Musa. Obviously, from the light of the scriptures also, they understood that a Nabi will come. When Sayyidina Musa came with his message, then the Quran says people were very skeptical in accepting his faith, knowing very well that the message of Moses was correct. simply because of the implications and the consequences from Pharaoh. So Pharaoh would subject a person like this to a host of torture and punish him and persecute him. But again, it was the lot of the youth of that time. The Quran said the youth, they have the conviction when they make their mind up. Wallahi, if they make their mind up on wrong, none can stop them. If they make their mind up on right, nothing comes in their way. Nothing comes in their way. The youth of that time, they stood up. And they said, we're going to accept the truth. And we will face Pharaoh with a naked eye. Look at him in his face. The Quran said, فَمَا آمَنَ لِمُوسَىٰ إِلَّا ذُرِّيَّةٌ مِّن قَوْمِهِ عَلَىٰ خَوْفٍ مِّن فِرْعَوْنِ. In the initial stages, at the inception of the message of Moses, it was the youth of that time who stood up and embraced the faith, paved the way for others, made it easier. And ultimately, the entire Bani Israel of 600,000 accepted Islam and accepted the teachings of Musa. But it was the youth who could mobilize such a big number. The hadith of Bukhari on the strength of Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu, Imam Bukhari quotes the chapter, Babun la yadkhulu ad-dajjal al-Madina, that Dajjal will be barred from entering into Medina. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَأْتِ الدَّجَّالِ وَهُوَ مُحَرَّمٌ عَلَيْهِ أَن يَدْخُلْ نِقَابَ الْمَدِينَةِ. He will try and get into Medina, but he will be barred by divine presence of the Malaika. As he comes close, يَنْزِلُ بَعْضَ السِّبَاخِ أَلَّتِي بِالْمَدِينَةِ. He will roam around on the outskirts of Medina. The people of Medina will be informed that Dajjal is outside. يَأْتِي إِلَيْهِ رَجُلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ خَيْرُ النَّاسِ. One person from Medina will come out to challenge Dajjal. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the riwayat of Bukhari on the strength of Abu Sa'id Khudri refers to this individual as the noblest person of that time. يَأْتِي إِلَيْهِ رَجُلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ خَيْرُ النَّاسِ أَوْ مِنْ خَيْرِ النَّاسِ. That is the difference of riwayat. He will then advance towards Dajjal. And he will point to Dajjal in his face and say, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّكَ دَجَّال الَّذِي حَدَّثَنَا عَنْكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ حَدِيثًا. I have no doubt in the fact, you are the very Dajjal that my Nabi prophesized. Dajjal will then look at the other people and say, أَرَأَيْتَ إِن قَتَلْتُ هَذَا ثُمَّ أَحْيَيْتُهُ هَلْ تَشُكُّونَ فِي الْأَمْرِ. Tell me, if I cause the instant death of this person and then I revive him, will you be convinced that I am the being to be worshipped? People will say, if you prove that, we will fall for you. Now we understand the gullible nature of people. Dajjal will then split him in half. The certain masses will follow. But this individual, he will address Dajjal and say, I am only convinced now so much more that you are Dajjal. Now there is another hadith which I have come across in Sirat al-Anbiya. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam describing this man said, Shabun mumtali'un shababa. This person who will have the guts of his conviction, who will have the might and the strength of his own power, he will be a youth in the prime of his life. Who has the talent, Allah forbid today, the young man has become the agent of Dajjal. Nay, he has become Dajjal himself. Only to know his talent is such, that my Nabi said, it is this young man that will stand up and resist the onslaught of Dajjal. 16 June, supposedly in South African political history, is Youth Day, which revives or commemorates the struggle and the effort of liberation by few youngsters who opposed certain policies of the previous regime, and perhaps they had given their life. Let me share with you a young man, also of African origin, of Abyssinian origin, who was born 46 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's migration to Medina Munawwara. I'm speaking of none other than Sa'id ibn Jubair. He was born in an era that was rich with Sahaba. It was the era of Sahaba. وَلَقَدْ أَدْرَكَ هَذَا الْفَتَى الْحَبَشِيُّ أَصْلًا أَنَّ الْعِلْمَ إِنَّمَا هُوَ الطَّرِيقُ الْقَوِيمُ الَّذِي يُوَصِّلُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. Despite the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had passed away, the zeal of knowledge and the desire to acquire knowledge, this was paramount in the heart of this young man. It is said about him as a little child, فَمُنْذُ نُعُومَةِ أَغْفَارِهِ كَانَ النَّاسُ يَرَوْنَهُ عَاكِفًا كَانَ النَّاسُ يَرَوْنَهُ إِمَّا عَاكِفًا عَلَى كِتَابِهِ يَتَعَلَّمْ أَوْ صَفًا فِي مِحْرَابِهِ يَتَعَبَّدْ. This boy, as he grew up, there was only two things in his life. Either you found this lad sitting with a kitab and studying, or you found him sitting in the masjid and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just as Allah forbid, today if you find a youngster averagely, either he's got a cigarette in his hand or he's busy with the phone. Recently, in this last week or so, I heard on the radio, on the USA report, a girl at the age of 13 in America, in Pennsylvania to be precise, that was on the morning show on the talk radio, she won an award. Now again, it's a question of its own, if this constitutes an award, is this really a merit? But be it as it may, we need to question our priorities. She won an award for sending the fastest text message, for SMSing the fastest message. How much did she win? $25,000. It's estimated that this girl prints out 8,000 SMSs a month. Now do some basic division that leaves you with 266 odd text messages a day. My question is, if this is the society that is becoming the future of tomorrow, divide the 266 by 24 hours or 12 hours going to sleep. What else can this child do? Again, I heard on that same report, I mean, this is, you know, openly it's coming out. There was a research that was, a survey that was conducted, that averagely today a child, 3-month-old child, is watching TV for 45 minutes. A 3-month-old child. By the time the child is 2, he or she is seen 90 minutes. Scientists say this is a very harmful trend for the development of the human faculty. If it persists like this, it's going to stagnate the mental growth of this child. Now this is the consequences we are facing. This young boy, either he had a kitab before him, or he was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used to recite the Quran, the entire Quran by night. And there was a verse of the Quran, when he used to read this, it used to give him a shiva. إِذِ الْأَغْلَالُ فِي أَعْنَاقِهِمْ وَالسَّلَاسِلُ يُسْحَبُونَ فِي الْحَمِيمِ ثُمَّ فِي النَّارِ يُسْجَرُونَ. Allah says, when the disbelievers will be shackled and they will be hurled into the hellfire, and then they will be made to drink the hot fire and the hot water that will be burning. Wallahi, it is mentioned when he used to read this verse as a youngster, he used to sob so profusely that it used to make the elderly people around him cry. He initially was based in Iraq, in Kufa. But this was an era where Hajjaj, the notorious bloodshedder, had his dominance and his sovereignty. So this youngster decided, for the safety of his iman, because if I present in the court of Hajjaj, either it's my life or my religion, and both are dear both are an asset to me. So he then sneaks out of Basra and Kufa, and he takes amnesty in Makkah. And for 10 years, as a young man growing up, he disseminated the knowledge of deen. He had profound knowledge. He learned from the likes of Abdullah ibn Abbas, from Aisha radiallahu anha, and a host of other sahaba. But tragically, after 10 years had passed, he was still a young man. For whatever reason, Allah knows best, one of the governors of Banu Umayyah, who were also under the umbrella of Hajjaj, they were posted to Makkah. And people had forewarned him, a man by the name of Khalid bin Abdullah, who carried a Muslim name but had nothing to do with Islam. People had warned him that, you know what, given your nature and the youth that throng around you and the impeccable character that you possess, the profound knowledge, it's not going to gel well with this governor who has a different agenda. Perhaps it's time you move on. So he said, you know what, I really feel ashamed. As a young man initially based in Basra, I then left there out of the fear of my life. I have come here to Makkah. Now one of the governors have been posted here. I feel ashamed to now flee from fate. If fate is that I have to die here, so be it. Whatever has to happen, so it will go. Bailey had said this, and few days later he was sitting with some of his companions when the men of Hajjaj came and intercepted him and apprehended him. When they apprehended him, he addressed his colleagues around him. Now this is a young man in the prime of his life, of African origin. What did he say? He said, "Ma arani illa maqtulan ala yaday dhalika al-zalim." Wallah, the way I look, my time is up and I'm going to die at the hands of this tyrant ruler. Then before they took him, he said, let me share something with you people. لَقَدْ كُنْتُ أَنَا وَصَاحِبَانِ لِي فِي لَيْلَةٍ عِبَادَةٍ. Myself and two of my companions very recently had spent a night exclusively in the worship of Allah. We will say we were on a hiking trip, we were on a swimming, we were on a fishing trip, we were hunting, whatever it was. We were on a night of ibadat. فَاسْتَشْعَرْنَا حَلَاوَةَ الدُّعَى فَدَعَوْنَا اللَّهَ بِمَا دَعَوْنَا. We initially thought we'll just spend 1-2 hours in ibadat. But before we got into the rhythm of ibadat, the next best thing, we felt an ecstasy in dua. Like you ask a youngster, he'll tell you, I just went And I went with my friend. I thought I'll pop one pill and I'll be back. Before I knew, I was popping pill after pill, woman after woman. The night was over and I didn't know where I was. How one sin leads to another, my brother? Wallah, one good leads to another. He said, we started the night of dua. فَاسْتَشْعَرْنَا حَلَاوَةَ الدُّعَى. Next best thing, we felt an ecstasy in dua. And we couldn't get ourselves off that worship mat. فَدَعَوْنَا اللَّهَ بِمَا دَعَوْنَا. And each one of us just cried to Allah profusely. And we felt such a bond with Allah. وَتَذَرَّعْنَا إِلَيْهِ بِمَا شَاءَ أَن نَتَذَرَّعَ. That we all echoed common du'as and supplications. Allah accept our life. The life of my two companions have been accepted. بَقِيْتُ أَنَا أَنْتَظِرْ. I'm the only youngster left behind. But I'm hopeful my du'a has not been rejected. My time has also come. They then shackled him up. And listen to this. As they then escort him out, his little daughter, he was a young man, he had a small daughter. طَلَعَتْ بُنَيَّةٌ صَغِيرَةٌ لَهُ. His little daughter ran out. Now can you imagine what a clash of emotions this was? Today's young man, he abandons wrong. And one SMS from that girl, he feels emotionally obliged. And then he reverts to his wrong. This is a young man who is ready to present his life, preserve his iman. The emotion that is interrupted by is his little daughter. I don't have a daughter, I have a son. But I know when at times you're flying abroad for a program and just the sight of your child and the innocence of your child, knowing that you plan to return, you're looking at your daughter in her eye, there's no return. The people that had escorted him, merciless. He looks at his daughter. فَتَشَبَّثَتْ بِهِ. She comes to the father. فَرَأَتْهُ مُقَيَّدًا وَالْجُنْدُ يَسُوقُونَهُ. She sees that her father is shackled and her father is being escorted. So she breaks down emotionally. تَشَبَّثَتْ بِهِ. She clings onto her father. وَجَعَلَتْ تَبْكِي وَتَنْشِدْ. And she started screaming and yelling. فَنَحَّاهَا عَنْهُ بِرِفْقٍ. He keeps his composure, keeps his balance. This is a young man who has priorities in order. Very gently he motions away. He keeps his tears behind. يَا بُنَيَّةُ قُولِي لِأُمِّكْ. Oh my daughter, tell your mom. Tell your mom, اسْبِرِي إِنَّ مَوْعِدَنَا الْجَنَّةِ. Tell her to persevere. I am going. I doubt I'll come back, my darling. But tell mommy, Allah will unite us in Jannat. Wallah, I am hopeful from Allah. If the young man of today, you don't have that clash of emotions. But I'm hopeful if you can put an end to haram. And you can drop that DVDs. And you can get rid of that music. I am optimistic from my kind Allah. He will give you no less reward than that what he gave to Sa'id ibn Jubair. This young man was then brought into the court of Hajjaj ibn Yusuf. Now listen to this chat. What a talk of chat room. We welcome you to the chat room where what your Allah forbid, your fantasies will be exploded. And I don't know what and what is happening. Listen to this chat. We welcome you to this chat room. You are live in this chat room, my brother. A chat between a young man who knew what life meant. He stood before Hajjaj ibn Yusuf. فَنَظَرَ إِلَيْهِ بِحِقْدٍ. Hajjaj as a tyrant cast a dirty glance at Sa'id ibn Jubair. Masmuk, what's your name, young man? He said, Sa'id ibn Jubair. My name is Sa'id ibn Jubair. Sa'id means fortunate. Jubair was his father's name, which essentially means one who rectifies and reforms. One of the names of Allah Ta'ala is Jabbar. Jabbar commonly translated as mighty and authority, but it also means one who reforms and rectifies. So Hajjaj in his arrogance looks at this young man and says, you are not Sa'id ibn Jubair. You are not fortunate. You are Shaqi ibn Kusayr. Shaqi meaning you are wretched. And your father is shattered. So Sa'id ibn Jubair says, بَلْ كَانَتْ أُمِّي أَعْلَمُ بِإِسْمِي مِنْ. My youngster knows how to chat with a woman. And what they say, what replies are free. Or the S, no, no, it's not free, it's nar. It's the fire of Jahannam. Wallah, it's not 20 rand and it's not 50 cent. Every reply, every SMS, every text is Allah's azab. Listen to this discussion and dialogue. He says, listen, Hajjaj, my mother knows my name better than you. My mother knows, my Nabi said, the greatest sacrifice, kalimatu haqqin inda sultanin jair, the proclamation of truth in the presence of a tyrant. There's nobody who has performed a more virtuous action. Fama taqulu fi Muhammad. What's your opinion of Muhammad? So Sa'id ibn Jubair said, which Muhammad are you talking? Ta'ni Muhammad ibn Abdullah salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. Are you referring to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, yes, I'm referring to. He said, well, then you must say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's your opinion about Muhammad? He said, well, Sayyidu Wuldi Adam, the leader of the offspring of Adam. سيد ولد آدم النبي المصطفى the selected prophet of Allah خير من بقي من البشر وخير من مضى the noblest of the living and the noblest of the deceased حمل الرسالة embraced prophethood أدى الرسالة discharged the obligation نصح لله ولكتابه ولعامة المسلمين وخاصتهم faithful to Allah faithful to the book of Allah faithful to the general message of the Muslims and to the rulers of the Muslims فما تقول في أبي بكر What's your take on Abu Bakr? You know, a youngster, he goes on a chat for hours and hours. فَمَا تَقُولُ فِي أَبِي بَكْرٍ What's your opinion on Abu Bakr? He said, هو الصديق, the truthful, خليفة رسول الله, the successor of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, مضى على منهاج النبي, followed diligently the life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, لم يغير ولم يبدل, did not alter himself in any way, عاش حميدا وقتل سعيدا, lived a noble life and died an enviable death. فَمَا تَقُولُ فِي عُمَرْ What's your take on Umar? هُوَ الْفَارُوقُ الَّذِي I wish my brother I was talking Arabic and you were understanding. I'm afraid that's not terminology that is common to us. Talk anything else and we understand. Unfortunately, the language of Quran has become an absent reality. هُوَ الْفَارُوقُ الَّذِي فَرَّقَ اللَّهُ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْحَقِّ وَالْبَاطِلِ He is that person through whom Allah separated and differentiated truth and falsehood. خيارة الله وخيارة رسوله The selected of Allah and the beloved of his Nabi مضى على منهاج صاحبين Followed his Nabi and followed Abu Bakr عاش حميدا وقتل شهيدا Lived a noble life and died as a martyr فما تقول في عثمان What is your take on عثمان He said المجهز لجيش العسرة The one who equipped the army of Tabuk الحافر بئر روما The one who dug the well of Roma and made the water available for the Muslims المشتري لنفسه بيتا في الجنة The one who secured an abode for Jannah for himself in this very world سهر رسول الله على ابنتين The son-in-law of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on two of his daughters namely رقية and أم كلثوم ولقد زوجه النبي بوحي من السماء My Nabi wedded Uthman to his two daughters according to divine revelation Uthman was not his selection that was the selection of Allah And وهو المقتول ظلما He was killed innocently and hence he is the oppressed Khalifa فما تقول في علي What is your take on علي He said ابن عم رسول الله The cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أول من أسلم من الفتيان The first youngster to accept Islam زوج فاطمة البتول The husband of the pure Fatima أبو الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة The father of the leader of the two youth of Jannah حسن and حسين حجاج said now let's talk serious talk with you فأي خلفاء بني أمية أعجب لك We that is the Banu Umayyah, the rulers. Out of all the rulers, which one impresses you the most? He said, أرضاهم لخالقهم. The one that has impressed is Allah the most, he impresses me the most. فأيهم أرضى للخالق. Which amongst them, specify, be specific, which amongst them, I wish the youth of this ummah. Wallah, my brother, when you walk out arrogantly with your hair spiked, And with that earrings, and with that attitude of yours, the riwayat of Bukhari, Nabi alayhi salam says, one young man was walking with pride and arrogance. Allah caused the earth to split. أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضَ فَإِذَا هِيَ تَمُورُ Do you feel you are out of the control and the grip of that Allah who is above you? Well, your actions denote that. What did he say? The one that pleased is Allah the most, that is the one that impresses me the most. Okay, be specific. Which one has pleased Allah the most? He said, عِلْمُ ذَلِكَ عِنْدَ الَّذِي يَعْلَمُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ The one who knows the external and internal, he can decide that, I can't decide that. فَمَا تَقُولُ فِيَّ Saeed, I want to ask you, what's your opinion about me? We know how a man mellows down to truth when it is boss, when it is seniors, when he's seen a job to secure. Yeah, his life is on the line. His neck is on the line. He said, أَنْتَ أَعْلَمُ بِنَفْسِكَ You know yourself better. Why should I tell you about you? What must I tell you? بَلْ أُرِيدُ أَنْ أَسْمَعْ مِنْكَ Saeed, I want to hear from you. What is your opinion about me? He said, إِذَنْ يَسُوءَكَ وَلَا يَسُرُّكَ If you want to hear, brace yourself for something unpleasant. I'm afraid you're not going to hear nice things about yourself. Now go for it. What is it? إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ مُخَالِفٌ لِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ تقدم على أمور تريد بها الهيبة وهي تقحمك في الهلكة وتدفعك إلى النار دفعا You openly violate the orders of Allah. You are a tyrant, you are a dictator. Which, ya Allahu Akbar. You openly violate the orders of Allah. Your only aim is to impress upon the people your fear, that they must fear you. And that's going to land you in problems and ultimately in hell. So Hajjaj said, أما والله لأقتلنك You are provoking me and enraging me. I will kill you. You know, in Arabic, they say, آخر سهم في كنانة الملوك. The last arrow in a king's quiver is, I'll kill you. The last arrow in a king's quiver, when he resorts to violence, it's a dialogue. Now look at the word of this young man. My young brother, you can only talk like this if you don't talk to haram woman. Then this is the strength Allah will give you. He said, أَمَا وَاللَّهِ لَأَقْتُلَنَّكَ Hajjaj said, I will kill you. He said, إِذَن تُفْسِدَ عَلَيَّ دُنْيَايَ وَأُفْسِدَ عَلَيْكَ آخِرَتَكَ If you kill me, you will destroy my life in this world and I will destroy your life in Akhirat. I will have no life in this world, but you will have no life in Akhirat. Innahu, once upon a time, the youth of this ummah made this entire ummah proud. This was the legacy. Today we drop our gazes down out of embarrassment and humiliation looking at our youth. You go to any mall and see what our youngsters are doing. What did he say? Innahu man ya'ti rabbahu mujrima فَإِنَّ لَهُ جَهَنَّمْ The Quran says, if you come as a criminal, there's no life for you. Hajjaj then tells him, اِخْتَرْ لِنَفْسِكَ اَيَّ قِتْلَةٍ شِئْتَ Saeed, decide how do you want to die. Decide how you want to die. Saeed said, can I rephrase that question? Let me ask you, وَاللَّهِ مَا تَقْتُلَنِي قَتْلَةً إِلَّا قَتَلَكَ اللَّهُ مِثْلَهَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ فَاخْتَرْ لِنَفْسِكَ أَنْتَ يَا حَجَّاج Hajjaj, the manner in which you're going to kill me, that is how Allah is going to punish you. Let me rephrase this. How would you prefer being punished in Akhirah? Don't ask me how do I wish to be killed. Let me rephrase it. Whatever you do to me, so will it be done to you. Decide how you like to be punished. And that is how you kill me. He said, أَفَتُرِيدُ أَنْ أَعْفُوَ عَنْكَ Okay, let's call it a close deal and I pardon you. He said, إِنْ كَانَ عَفْوٌ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ I don't fall for your temptations. If we conclude on pardon, it's the decree of my Allah. You've never pardoned me and you can never pardon me. أَسَّيْفَ وَالنَّتَعَ يَا غُلَامِ Bring the sword and drop the mat and kill this wicked man. So he smiles. He smiles. Hajjaj says, وَمَا تَبَسُّمُكَ One is that young man who smiles at a tyrant in his eye. That smile brings him close to Allah. One is the young man who has a smile flirting every woman. That smile only draws him closer to hell. What makes you smile, O young man? He said, عَجِبْتُ مِنْ جَرَاءَتِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَحِلْمِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ I'm smiling looking at your arrogance and Allah's kindness towards you. I'm just marveling at how the clemency of Allah, the grace of Allah. You are getting arrogant upon arrogant. And Allah is just being calm and patient and displaying clemency with you. So he says, اُقْتُلْهُ يَا غُلَامْ Slaughter him. So he turns towards Qibla. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَتَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ Once upon a time, this is how the young man of this ummah died. Today my youngster is dying with a haram woman, with music blasting, going towards a club. Allah alone knows the destiny of this man. As he turns towards Qibla and he reads, إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي I turn towards Allah. Hajjaj says, حَوِّلُوهُ عَنِ الْقِبْلَةِ Turn the wicked man away from Qibla. So when they turn him away, he says, أَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ Wherever you turn me, my Allah is there. Hajjaj says, drop him on the earth. When they drop him on the earth, he says, مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى From the sand we created you, to the sand we return you. Hajjaj said, slaughter this man. مَا رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا أَدْعَى مِنْهُ لِآيَاتِ الْقُرْآنِ I've never seen a human and a young man who understood Quran better than Sayyid ibn Jubayr. He lifted his hands. He said, Allah, I patiently persevere and happily accept this death. But I have a request, my Lord. Allahumma la tusallit al-hajjaj ala ahadin ba'di. Allah, let me be the last victim of hajjaj. Allah, I think it's time you grab the hand of this tyrant. Allah, I think it's time you put an end and you seize him. Now a tyrant like hajjaj on the dua of a young man. Look at what Allah does to him. Hajjaj then mercilessly kills this person. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, وَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ قُتِلَ سَعِيدُ بْنُ جُبَيْرٍ وَمَا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا وَهُوَ مُحْتَاجٌ إِلَىٰ عِلْمٍ The death of Sa'id is such, it is not mourned by his family or by the nation. This entire earth today mourns the death of this young man. And I guess even the angels share in our grief today. Wallah, once upon a time the young man was such, on his death, the entire world mourned his death. Wallahi laqad qutila Sa'id ibn Jubayr. After that, this tyrant only had misery in his life. Cutting a long story short, when he died, someone seen him in a dream. They said, Hajjaj, how did you fare before Allah? He said, قَتَلَنِي بِكُلِّ قَتِيلٍ قَتَلْتُهُ قَتْلَةً وَقَتَلَنِي بِسَعِيدِ بْنِ جُبَيْرٍ سَبْعِينَ قَتْلًا. In lieu of every life I claimed, my Allah made me taste the agony of death once. But when I interfered with Sa'id ibn Jubair, Allah said, you'll die 70 times. Understand the talent of the youth. Let me leave you with an incident. Bear with me in time and I will wrap up. Hassan and Hussein, the two grandsons of my Nabi. Hassan was 7 when my Nabi closed his eyes. Hussein was 6 when my Nabi closed his eyes. Radiyallahu anhuma. The riwayat of Bukhari, my Nabi put Hassan on the minbar and said, إِنَّ بْنِي هَذَا سَيِّد. The son of mine is a leader. وَلَعَلَّ اللَّهَ أَن يُصْلِحَ بِهِ بَيْنَ فِئَتَيْنِ عَظِيمَيْنِ. He will grow up and he has such talent. He won't divide this ummah. Wallah, he will be instrumental in uniting this ummah. From childhood, the Prophet prophesies the future of this young man. Hussein, the riwayat of Hakim, my Nabi said, Husaynun minni wa ana min Hussein. Hussein is part of me and I am part of Hussein. Allahumma ahibba man ahabba Husaynan. Allah, the one that loves Hussein, you love him. Hassan radiallahu anhu resembled the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the chest going upwards. Hussein radiallahu anhu resembled the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the chest going downwards. The riwayat of Musnad Ahmad and Mustadrak, days after the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ali and Abu Bakr are walking after Asr Salah. And Hassan radiallahu anhu, the grandson, the elder grandson, is playing with the children. Yal'abu ma'al ghilman. Abu Bakr looked at him, advanced towards him, picked him up, hugged him and said, Bi Abi Shabihun bin Nabiyyi, Laysa Shabihan bi Aliyyin. Bi Abi Shabihun bin Nabiyyi. Wallah Hassan, when I look at you, you remind me, you're a perfect replica of my Nabi. He looked at Ali and he said, Ali, no offense, but he doesn't look like you. No offense, but he doesn't look like you. You know, sometimes in one of the slightly don't look like a mullah. No problem, as long as he signs mullah, we don't have a problem. Laysa Shabihan bi Aliyyin. He doesn't resemble you. Now let me tell you, just one thing I share. I wish I could open up more. Today's youngsters, come to me and I will show you arrogance. You can't tell the child one thing. You cannot discipline him in any way. Sheer arrogance and absurdity. These two youngsters, these two young boys, the grandchildren of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The hadith I quoted in the beginning, Ibn Asakir mentions it. Man sarrahu an yandhur ila sayyidi shababi ahli al-jannah. You want to admire the leader of the youth of Jannah? Look at my Hussein. He will lead all the youth. Look at my Hussein. Hassan and Hussein radiallahu anhuma, etiquette, manners, respect, which is absent in our youth. Generally, I'm not pointing to anyone. They seen one elderly person, he was performing wudu and salah incorrectly. Look at the wisdom, the diplomacy, the composure. They went to this elderly man, they said, نَحْنُ الشَّابَّانِ وَأَنْتَ شَيْخٌ كَبِيرٌ. We are youngsters, you are an elderly person. رُبَمَا تَكُونُ أَعْلَمْ بِأَمْرِ الْوُذُوءِ وَالصَّلَاةِ مِنَّا. Being elderly, you will be more learned. We are going to perform wudu before you, uncle. Please rectify our mistakes. Please show us how we perform in salah incorrectly. Both of these grandchildren then performed wudu adequately, promptly, correctly. The elder, فَتَنَبَّهَ الشَّيْخ. The elderly man understood the wisdom of these children, the diplomacy of these children, the kind interaction. They did not insult, they did not victimize, yet they politely conscientized him of his wrong. Once upon a time, our youth were telling us what to do. It was Hassan and Hussein who went to that man and told him, uncle, this is the polite way. He realized, he hugged them, he kissed them. He said, these are the grandchildren of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is only them and them alone that can teach us. Today we cannot tell our children, wallah, the future is looking bleak. We make dua to the Almighty Allah that he hold our children in this era. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them guidance, respect and honor, that once again they can become an asset to the ummah. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.